In this video, we're going to build on our sending a simple message tutorial and show you how to send a message with parameters. Using the same setup from that tutorial, double-click on the first processor and go to the Triggers tab. Next to On Entry, use the red X to remove the old trigger, and then the green plus sign to add a Send Message trigger. Use Current for both the From and To text boxes, because we want the processor to send a message to itself. Then change the value of parameter 1 to 1. Remove the trigger for on message as well, and replace it with close and open ports based on cases. Use the drop-down menu to select close input, open paren current, close paren for case value 1, and then use the green plus sign to add a new case value of 2, and select open input, open paren current, close paren from the drop-down menu. Depending on if the message received has a message parameter 1 value of either 1 or 2, one of these events will trigger. Click OK to save and close the window. Double-click on the second processor, go to the Triggers tab, and remove the OnExit trigger and replace it with Send Message. The message will be sent to inObject, open paren current, comma 1, close paren, and will have a parameter 1 value of 2. Click OK to save and close the window. Let's click Reset and run the model. Each time an item enters the first processor, a message is sent to itself with a value of 1. And since that satisfies the first case of our onMessage trigger, the current processor's input port is closed. Once an item exits the second processor, though, another message is sent with a value of 2, satisfying the second case of the onMessage trigger and reopening the input port. Thank you for watching. For more information on FlexSim products, or to view more tips and tricks for successful modeling, please visit www.flexsim.com.